Wilson, and I'm here to make an art talk about my work and show at the Kentuck Gallery. The title of the show is Creations of a Curious Sort, and the reason that title really fits the show is that all the things are, you kind of wonder what was the source and what was she thinking. And so that's the curious sort part. I am an artist who works in clay and encaustic wax. And I have combined the two elements together to create a finish on my pieces with the encaustic wax. As a child, I loved telling stories at night, watching the lightning bugs and telling ghost stories and stories about people that lived in the neighborhood, always making it up, of course. And the other thing that my sister and I used to do is melt crayons on top of our little electric radios that were beside our beds and watch all the colors blend together. Mother didn't end up liking that. But I think I go back to that when I work in my encaustic wax, because I truly enjoy watching the colors flow together and create different color combinations and patterns. And I was an art major. I've taken lots of art workshops. And I opened a gallery called the Maralyn Wilson Gallery in 1973. And did that, although I was still doing my artwork, I did not do it full-time until I retired. And when I retired, I started doing it full-time, and it's been the best thing that ever happened to me because I can't get bored. And it's been wonderful for the pandemic. I love staying at home and working, and most of the work in my show is a result of working during the pandemic. I discovered encaustic wax when the Birmingham Museum of Art had a encaustic wax workshop. And it was the first time I'd ever seen it or worked with it. And through the years, I finally went to New York to R&F Studios and took a few classes and learned all different techniques and how to use it in the best of its ability. And it's been, it's always a mystery. You're always really pleased, or not pleased, because it's easy to change. But the encaustic wax itself is a mixture of, it's beeswax and resin crystals. And you mix those two together, and when the wax hardens, it has a nice, hard, durable surface that you can polish and keep it clean and fresh looking. No matter how old it is, you can even go back 10 years later and look at a spot on there and say, I wish I had not done that, and just scrape it off and put something else in place. Clay has always been something that I wanted to do ever since I was a child. I love the idea of sculpture. And I started doing clay probably five, six years ago. And I love, as the clay is forming, if you form the clay piece, the personalities that develop, and they become like your friend, and you actually feel as if these are real people in your life. And since I love doing encaustic wax paintings, I thought, during the pandemic I came up with this, I will do borrow-leaf clay on top of an encaustic wax painting. Even though encaustic wax is very durable, you don't want to leave it in your car where it will melt in the summer, or leave it in your car and have it freeze in the winter. It's very repairable, which is much better to me than when I was working in oil. I feel like it's a very exciting medium for all people to try. All of my work has a story involved in it. As I do it, like in the rainbow maker and the human extruder, those are made up stories about something that I wish could really happen in real life, although they're very imaginative and fairy tale like. The rainbow maker is the story of a man who has set up a rainbow making shop on the cloud, and he pedals and pedals his bicycle to make the machine work, and after a good rain, his beautiful rainbows shoot out of his machine and light up in the sky. But and even with every, I could write a story about everything I do, but there's some things I want to leave to the viewer to say, I know the story behind this, and not tell them, not lead them. But some of the more elaborate pieces I like to lead you. The story comes as a process. As I'm working on it, I start thinking about the story and working and writing it down. And I have a friend who is a wonderful writer who always corrects my terrible writing. But as far as the stories go, I feel like it kind of opens a door for the viewer to go into another world and start imagining, if these could really be true, how wonderful it would be. I look at the stories for my pieces as a memory that I have from my childhood when I was making up things all the time. And I enhance my memory stories and go off and make them more fantastic. The stories are, to me, as important as the artwork sometimes, because you start making up the story of the piece as you're looking at it once you read my story. The lockdown affected it totally. I took lots of online workshops and learned so much. John Natalotis in California had a famous artist that I've heard about in the clay world for years give a workshop. And they each one was so informative and taught you a new technique. I worked all the time in the studio. I didn't go anywhere because I was not going to catch the COVID. And I just put all my energy into that. And then to me, it was one of my most wonderful parts of my life because I really enjoyed it. Coming by. That's one main thing.